Hello and welcome to another video. Today we are going to create pixel art. I'm Sparkman, by the way. Today we're gonna make something like Cubert. Alright, so for this example I'm using Adobe Photoshop, but you can use anything you like, Microsoft Paint or any other program that lets you work with pixels. Alright, so I'm gonna go file new, and I'm going to change the size of this to 320 by 240. Alright, I'm going to zoom in super close, and I'm going to select my pen tool, and let's make a new layer, and I'm going to place two pixels, and I'm going to make another five here, five sets of twos. Okay, so let's make the first one 2, 3, 4, and 5. Let's do the same thing for the right 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay, I'm going to copy this. Let's bring it up. And maybe it can go a little higher. Let's join this here. Oops. And I'm going to merge these two layers. So now it's just one piece. And let's do the same thing from the left. Two pixels. 1, 2, 2, 3, 4. And 5. Let's do the same thing from the right. 2 pixels. 1, 2, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Alright, so I'm going to take my eraser, and I'm going to set this to pencil mode as well. And we can probably frame this a little bit. Take out the pixels from the corners. Alright, so let's colorize the cube. Place green on top. Let's try brown on the side. Very dark brown. And very light brown on the left. Now it looks like Minecraft. Alright, so let's shade this a little bit. I'm going to darken this a little bit more. Super dark for the highlight. Or the shadow, I should say. Let's do the same thing for the light part of the color. Let's make it darker. And maybe that's not dark enough, it needs to be darker. That looks a little better. That's not too bad. Let's do the same thing with the green. Let's grab a darker kind of green. And our shadows, I guess, will be around here on top. Alright, so here is the cube. I'm going to select my move tool. And I'm going to hold shift and alt. Actually, you only need to hold alt to duplicate things. Okay. Let's drag this. Let's place it there. Make sure you're not getting a double line. Let's do it again. And that's looking not too bad. Now, if this looks like this, all you need to do is drag the layer to the back. Let's make some sort of bridge or something. Now, another thing you can do is that you can select four different pieces, or more than four, and going to combine this by pressing Control E, and you can create a larger pieces. And you kind of get the idea that you can build just about anything with this. Right, so I'm going to make one more level below this one. I guess I could create a new layer, and I could probably paint this with a darker kind of green. super dark. And I could create some plants. Alright, that doesn't look too bad so far. I'm going to use the polygonal select tool. Alright, so I'm going to set this shadow, I'm going to set this layer to overlay. Okay. This one too. So it will just simply darken the bottom. Touch to this, let's change the background to blue. Maybe I can add noise to this. And I'm going to scale this image to 1280 by 960. And I'm going to use a nearest neighbor to preserve the pixelation. And you can see that this is now an HD pixel picture. Alright, so I'm going to grab one of these cubes and I'm going to delete the rest. Delete. Okay. And I'm going to create a cube tower. Alright. I'm going to do the same thing. I'm going to clone this and put it in place. Make sure you're not getting that double line. This one needs to move a little bit. That looks not too bad. Let's paint it some old school blue. Alright, so I guess I could select all of this and combine them all at once to create one object. So you can see that this is extremely easy. There's nothing to it. Alright, so thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Follow me on Twitter. Like the video. And I will see you in the next episode.